Hello everyone, this is Barry Basnett. I thought I'd share another video about how you can capture and share heritage. This is one of my favourite places on the planet. It's the church or the Cathedral of the Isles on Cumbrae off the west coast of Scotland. And I was digging about in the graveyard exploring. That actually is the Mason's mark of this monument. It's in a beautiful part of the world, obviously on a gorgeous summer's day. But this is an example of what we call a smart 360. Well, there are many ways to capture heritage using LiDAR, using photogrammetry and dronage. This is another way of doing it. What I can do here, or what I've done here, is I've stitched together 18 images to produce a 1.1 gigapixel image. This has been viewed on a website. So you can share this with whoever you wish. You can share it with your visitors, your colleagues, other academics, people doing conservation so they can get a really close-up picture of what they're having to deal with. Use it for your marketing. Provide a virtual tour for education, school visits to take away with them. All sorts of different applications. Now this image took about a minute to capture, so it doesn't take long at all. And we can use it as part of a virtual tour of the building. So let's skip round to the front door and have a look here. So the Cathedral of the Isles is also a college where you can go and stay, have a quiet time. It's in a beautiful part of the world. So you could use this for your marketing if you wish to advertise and show it. But you could also use it from practical things for looking at inspection, dilapidation reports, and all sorts of different lovely applications that will help you speed up and allow lots of different people to be there from anywhere, as we call it. Now, there's many different ways. You've seen lots of examples of 3D models done by drones, but what about the rest of the building, the bits that's inside, the 95% of the other building we have to do research on or photograph or monitor? So we popped inside the church now. It's quite small, beautiful, full of lots of historic artifacts that tell the story of the church and how it served its community over the years. Again, this is taken inside the church with 18 images. Lighting and photography inside these places is really tricky because you've got no lighting as such, just lighting from the outside, which creates its own challenges. But again, this image took about a minute and a half to take and allows us to capture in incredible detail lots of the artifacts, the objects that all enhance and tell the story of the structure and how it's been used. But let's pop up to the choir and have another look and take another view of it. Click, and here we go. This is looking back down to where we took the original camera position. We've managed to eliminate lots of the shadows so that we can see the detail in the roof, but we can actually see and navigate through. And one thing to remember about this photograph is, if you want to, you can actually reconstruct 3D models from this. A lot of people don't get that, but actually you can. Why? Because of the expense of modeling things when you can just have this to give a really good view of what it's like to be there from anywhere on the planet. You can always be really nosy and get into, see what this music is he playing there, okay? Oh, I'm not allowed to touch the organ, that's handy to know. But as you can see, we can get and zoom around. This is completely interactive. As I say, this is on a website, or you could use a static image to tell us to inspect or use it for conservation, dilapidation reports, all sorts of things. To help us, we'll navigate and relate the story of this. Obviously, this is 1883. The Bishop of Argyll was a big part of the story of this lovely little church. Zooming in to get the details of the carving. Let's just zoom out again, have another look and a scan around the altar. I'll leave it in one place just so you can have a look and take all the image in. But this took about a minute and a half to take, and it's online. You can look at it, zoom in, play about with it, share it. Okay, that's a quick tour of what Smart 360 can deliver. If you've got any questions, if you've got any queries, you want to know more about it, please feel free to DM me at my LinkedIn. And look forward to hearing from you. Okay, thank you.